fate has smiled on these teams once. Which team will catch your eye again in this second round matchup between the New Mexico State Aggies and the Virginia Tech Hokies?
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Hokies should be in for an easy one tonight, Dick. What do you see as the keys to their success?
The keys are very simple, my friend. First of all, work the ball to the interior to your post players. Let them be your option number one offensively. Second of all, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. Third, don't let your man beat you to the rebound.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action. Gave it up. He shoots from the baseline. He drains it.
Push it up basketball. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. Basket falls despite the contact. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Count that as a personal foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
The ball goes out of play. Here's a flash from the high post. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I think a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Strips the ball. Trying to draw the foul. Number 13 with a finger roll. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. We're Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The Aggies go to the line for the first time in this game.
Concentrate. Better concentrate on that free throw line.
Second one is no good. He grabs the rebound.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Nice job of dribbling off the screen, but the shot just didn't fall.
The center gets the ball. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He's got some room. And up. And sinks it.
Here's another look at the play.
Into the low block, playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
Ante tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed. Here he is, strips the ball loose.
Diggs, supplying pressure and looking for the steal.
In addition to the pressure defense, they're going for some aggressive steals as well. Look at that spacing.
Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
And the ball goes out of play. Dick, this is what we look forward to all year long, the NCAA tournament in the first half that's this close.
Well, both clubs really executing really well. I tell you, it's going to come down to who's going to play tougher on the defensive side. Really taking away stops because the rhythm offensively by both clubs has been sensational.
The Hokies will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here.
Watch out, the 5-second count is getting close, Brad.
The point guard with the ball. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
They work it around. perimeter. Looks at the three.
He got his jumper off by running that defender into the screen. There's the trap.
Way off target. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
The point guard takes the pass, fakes the shot. Had a momentary look from 3-point land. They're working around the perimeter, trying to feed the low block. There they come with a double team to stop it. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
And the ball goes out of bounds. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love it. Looking for a good shot. Number 13 is...
Ooh, look at a shot block. We got some contact. Nice hops.
They still don't score. Here's a flash from the post up high. In the paint. For two. And in and out. Shot clock is dead.
Up and inside.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He launches a three. The shot's off target. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
Great anticipation defensively.
Throws up the prayer. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. At the end of the first half, the Aggies trail by one. It's been a tight one thus far, Mr. Vitale. What play do you think set the tone here tonight?
This trifecta was the key for me, Brad. It opened up the game in the first half. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep up the outside shooting in the second.
All right, Dick, let's get back to the action as the two teams are just about ready to start the second half. New Mexico State seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Both teams looking to get things going here. It's stolen. Fast break opportunity here. There's the pick. There's the roll.
That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
On the dribble, gives it up. White pump fakes and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Tries for two. The small forward takes the feed. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to dive the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Got a man in high post.
This defender is resilient. Still applying pressure.
Down inside. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Off the rim and no good.
Set that screen away.
For the bucket. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. In and out. He keeps his dribble as they reset. There's a high screen. For for the deuce. He puts it in with contact and all. For two, perfectly executed. Dumps it in. The power forward handles the pass. There's a double team waiting there. And he missed. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us here.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Erin. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Goes up for two. Rims out. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Erin Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Aaron's right about that. Just about ready for play to resume. That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I told you there was a lot of time, Brad.
The low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
The power forward receives the pass. He shoots from the top of the circle. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action. What a big throw!
Step back out onto the court.
STOP. This place will be off the charts if they can get a stop here, Brad.
The ball goes out of bounds. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A. This place will be deafening if they can score here.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. The defense is really commanding the tempo.
Hey, they're keeping them out of sync. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
High post player flashing. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries the three ball. Off the rim and no good. They're going to duke it out in overtime.
We're going to see who's got the legs, baby. This is the home stretch. At the end of the second half, it's a dead heat. These teams are going into overtime.
NCAA tournament, and it is overtime, a tournament game. Two evenly matched teams, Dick. This has been great throughout regulation. I can't wait for the OT.
I tell you, we got two evenly matched clubs that have really responded. The PTPers are playing well. The stars, the coaches have their teams prepared. And it's all going to get down, I believe, to the free throw line at the end of this game. The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
small forward gets the pass. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Comes up empty. The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The ball goes out of play. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Carson handles the feed with a block. And the ball goes out of play. Well, Dick, what's the front court production looking like to you?
Well, you know, Brad, your bigs really can influence how your teams play. Rebound, blocking shots, altering shots are all very important skills which your big players should possess.
He hits it. On the dribble, gives it up. The power forward receives the ball. Well, the defender goes down, but there's no call either way.
Wow, no call right there. I think that was a good call, though, by the official.
This is just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here. They move it into the front court. And the ball goes out of bounds. If they can get a basket here, Dick, this crowd will erupt. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. But good.
Here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Oh, what a hard screen there. Looking for a good shot. Here's a double team. Takes it off him. Fast break possibility coming. For two. Up. Easy one. 6 points is the difference.
Wow, do they need a basket badly, Brad? Momentum will decide it.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
You're going to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team. I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead is down to three. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle. Look at that spacing.
In the paint. Tries for two. Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Aaron's right about that, Dick. Well, let's see who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
Gave it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. Wide open for the shot. Picked off. for the deuce.
Better foul quick.
That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And the clock stopped for the foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
He goes to the line for the first time.
Got it.
Makes the second.
Timeout on the floor. It's a close one. The trigger fingers are getting itchy, baby. This one's too close to call.
Let's get back to the action. It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Looks for a three-pointer. White is trying to get the fans involved now.
I think he feels the importance of this defensive possession, Brad.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Virginia Tech is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way.